With the FNAF multiverse being introduced with the Fazbear Fanverse initiative, it's safe to say that now anything is possible. And since time traveling ball pits and animatronic mech suits are now canon, I hate to think about what's coming next. But what if we look back on some older games and see how the fans have improved them over the years? That's what we're exploring today. Greetings gamers, welcome back to Top 10 Gaming. I'm Connor Monroe and this is the Top 10 Scary FNAF Mods. Let's do it. In at 10, Scott Cawthon. Yes, that's right. Scott Cawthon is in Ultimate Custom Night. Okay, well, not normally in a sense, but you actually need to install this mod for it to work. But this mod, along with most of the mods on this list, comes from Elliot Robo on DeviantArt, which is honestly the last place I expected to find Ultimate Custom Night mods. So that's why these are all mostly going to be from him. Scott in this mod actually replaces the phone guy, since most of these mods require you to replace an animatronic, since that's just how the coding works, but still. Instead of Scott Cawthon talking as phone guy, you get Scott Cawthon talking as Scott Cawthon. It's not really scary in the normal sense, but rather because of the sheer implication that Scott being present in his own world would create, and the amount of work I would have to do to explain it, only for nobody to care because it didn't come from MatPat. Yeah, that's my life. That's why it's scary. In at 9, Fixed Trap. Scrap Trap is one of the most pointlessly controversial characters in FNAF history. Most people thought that it was just a more rundown Spring Trap, and others assumed that it was an entirely separate character. Which in some ways makes sense given that Scrap Trap's head is much larger than Spring Trap's, but then that caused a load of people to think that Mike was Spring Trap, and that's simply not the case. But this mod from, again, Elite Robo replaces Scrap Trap with a fixed version of the Spring Bonnie suit that he's wearing, which makes it seem less scary in theory, but it's highly unsettling. It's so smooth and the head shape is so odd, it like looks like you're looking at a skull. I get uncomfortable looking at it. So yeah, if you want to fix Scrap Trap that still sets you on edge, use this. Now for God's sakes, please take it away. In at 8, Alistor. Hasbin Hotel is an American adult animated web series created by Vinny Vizipop Madurano on YouTube. It was made entirely by freelance animators and is largely financed by his Patreon followers. The official pilot was released on YouTube on October 28, 2019, and on November 6, 2019, Madurano stated on Patreon that there was no release date for the second episode yet. By August 2020, the show developed a dedicated fan base, with the 31-minute pilot receiving over 61 million views as of May of this year, a rise from 32 million views in May of 2020. On August 7, 2020, it was also announced that A24 had picked up Hasbin Hotel for a full television series. Alistor, the radio demon, is an overlord of hell in the show. His voice sounds like it's coming through a radio, complete with static sound effects and theme music. He offers his services to Charlie in order to help her maintain her goal of running the hotel, but only for his own amusement. And they're added into Ultimate Custom Night by Charlie B. Jr. on Game Jolt and replaces Funtime Foxy. This is the only mod that's made by a different mod author on this list. I'm sorry, but that's just how it worked out. And it's 7, Into the Pit Spring Bonnie. If you've seen the cover of Into the Pit, you'll know about this Into the Pit Spring Bonnie, the main antagonist of the story of the same name. And by the same name, I mean the name is Into the Pit, not Into the Pit Spring Bonnie. Either way, this version of Spring Bonnie is basically a nightmare version of the character, except more repaired than the other nightmare animatronics. Because let's be honest, in this series, a fully repaired animatronic with no damage in the style of the FNAF 1 robots is actually terrifying. I don't know why these proportions and this style of animatronic is just so creepy to me, but it is. And while it may not be as common of a thought to add the Fazbear Frights cover characters into Ultimate Custom Night, well, maybe aside from Fetch, I think that they're worth it. As I'm sure you could expect, this mod is from Elite Robo on DeviantArt, and the post has two links to download the mod from, one being a Discord link and the other being some weird file sharing service that isn't Mediafire or Dropbox, so I personally wouldn't trust it, but hey, it's up to you. And 6th, Twisted Ones. Yep, you heard me right. You can have the Twisted Animatronics in Ultimate Custom Night for the simple price of replacing a couple animatronics. The ones this mod from Elite Robo adds are Twisted Freddy, Bonnie, and Foxy. There isn't a Twisted Wolf specifically. I think that Foxy is meant to be Twisted Wolf, except just more themed. But I don't even know if there was a Twisted Foxy. I didn't read the book. My sister has it, I just haven't borrowed it yet. However, Elite Robo has mentioned in the comments that they're willing to add additional characters in further mod updates if the models get released. Since currently, the model models are from a Steam community page. And since this was already an update made back in Halloween 2020, it's been over a year, so I'm sure that other models have been released. It could also help explain why there's no Twisted Wolf and instead Twisted Foxy. There was just no model for it. But if you want to make a model for like Twisted Chica or something and send it to Elite Robo, I'm sure they'd be grateful. Halfway through in at number 5, Scrap Orville Elephant. Orville Elephant isn't a particularly scary character. This remains the same for the rest of the mediocre melodies. However, this Scrap Orville mod using a model by user HoloPackZoom is honestly terrifying. Scrapping animatronics always makes them scarier. And with the lore implications that the original Orville added with some of his death lines in the game, I can only imagine what a Scrap Orville would add. While the page doesn't explicitly state it, I'm guessing that the mod would replace the original Orville to help him look like just more of a scrap animatronic. And to be frank, this is probably the scariest scrap animatronic that I've seen, even if it is fan-made. Ooh, should we make like a scary fan-made scrap animatronics list? I think that would be cool. Oh, I'll write that down. And at 4, Dark Springtrap. Oh yeah, here's where we're getting to the good stuff. Dark Springtrap in Ultimate Custom Night is a mod that replaces Rockstar Chica with Dark Springtrap and RS, and Rockstar Chica's sign with a spare puppet mask. Dark Springtrap is basically Springtrap after the FNAF 3 fire, but before Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria Simulator. The concept of Springtrap is already pretty dark, with a serial killer getting trapped inside of an animatronic suit, unable to die because he's being possessed. But combine that with the whole FNAF 3 fire burning him slightly, and then you have some decent nightmare fuel. Springtrap isn't really that scary of a character, but Dark Springtrap certainly helps make him freakier, especially because most of the actual William body in this model seems to be gone. It's mostly an empty shell that actually technically makes him more of an animatronic than the original Springtrap, since normal Springtrap isn't an animatronic, it's just a dude trapped in an animatronic suit. I will die on this hill. Springtrap is not an animatronic, he is a dude who has just been augmented. Basically. Facts. Getting close to the end in at number 3, Hallow's Eve. Now we're starting to get to the collections, which definitely are going to be at the top, because let's be honest, the more the scarier, am I right? Instead of the more the merrier, pardon the pun. Elite Robo made a mod for Dreadbear and Grim Foxy from the Five Nights at Freddy's Help Wanted DLC Curse of Dreadbear that replaces Nightmarion and Ennard. And we all know how much I love the Help Wanted DLC, especially since Grim Foxy is my favorite animatronic at this point. But these animatronics are definitely going to be freaky being added to a game when they hadn't really been created yet. Oh god, imagine the lore that would come from them being in this game. I don't care how many jump scares or whatever that I have to deal with, the scariest part of Five Nights at Freddy's will always be the lore, no matter what, okay? If it has any lore implications, no matter what it is, I will run away screaming. I mean, I would run now, but there's kind of like a wall here, so I can't run. And ultimately, in at number 2, Fan Game Trio. The Fan Game Trio mod pack is a mod that replaces Toy Bonnie as Pop Goes the Weasel, Toy Chica as Candy the Cat, and Withered Bonnie as Ignited Bonnie. These characters are from the three popular fan games, Pop Goes, Five Nights at Candy's, and The Joy of Creation. Ironically, all of which are coming to the Fazbear Extended Universe thanks to the Fazbear Fanverse Initiative, which is certainly interesting since this mod for Ultimate Custom Night was released in 2019, meaning it predates the announcement for the Fanverse, which occurred in 2020. So technically, this mod in a way could in theory be canon, but I'm not even going to get into that because let's be real, that would drive me too crazy. I'll let MatPat handle this one, even though I know for a fact that he won't, because come on, he shouldn't even try to step to me. I say that only because he has absolutely no idea who I am, and I'm okay with that at this point. But yeah, if you want to experience the Fazbear Extended Universe, there you go. All you need to do is get this mod by Elite Robo again, because of course it is. And finally, in at number 1, Bago Puppets. I think we all know how I feel about the puppet and the various different fan-made versions of the puppet that we've discussed on this channel, particularly the Reaper puppet. Luckily, this mod does not feature the Reaper puppet from the Final Night series, but rather the security puppet and the stylized puppet created by Tofu Kaj. That's probably not the right way to say it, but if I say it the way I'm guessing it's really pronounced, we make it demonetized. However, this mod replaces Nightmarion and the puppet respectively, and honestly, that's all I can really say. The stylized puppet in this game is absolutely terrifying, and I hate that this thing creeps me out so much. I feel like I'm the phone guy. My favorite animatronic is a version of Foxy, that being Grim Foxy, and I'm always creeped out by alternate versions of the puppet, just like the phone guy thinks that the puppet is always thinking. But luckily, these animatronics aren't real and can't actually hurt me. I think, man. Whenever I end up having a kid and like they want to go to Chuck E. Cheese for some reason, they're always going to wonder why I either say no or I'm extremely cautious around these goddamn animatronics and the people in the Chucky suit. Like, they won't understand the struggle of having to talk about this series day after day. This series is gonna mess me up more than high school. Oh yeah. There we have it, friends, the top 10 scary FNAF mods. What's your favorite FNAF mod, if any, and who do you want to see be added to Ultimate Custom Night next? Be sure you let me know down below. I kind of mumbled my way through that. Thank you all so much for watching. I have been in Shower Man Connor Monroe, and I'll see you in another video.